Do you know about the woman who saved the American space program? How about the woman who helped advance the treatment of leprosy? Can you name the first American woman to receive a Ph.D. in chemistry? Their accomplishments were nearly lost to history, but now Reaction celebrates some of the great unsung women of chemistry. In 1957, the Soviet Union launched the first Earth-orbiting satellite, Sputnik. When the first pings of that satellite were heard in the U.S., scientists went into overdrive. At the time, most American rockets were still exploding at the launch pad. And if they made it into air, they didn't have enough power to get into orbit. The answer to our power problem was better fuel, and that's exactly where Mary Sherman Morgan comes in. Mary worked at North American Aviation, the company tasked with finding a better rocket fuel. She was the only woman out of 900 scientists working at North American Aviation, and the only one without a college degree. Mary and her team developed a new propellant cocktail called Hydine to power the Army's Jupiter C rocket, which was developed by a much more famous Wernher von Braun. On January 31st, 1958, Jupiter C, with the help of Hydine, delivered America's first satellite to space. Dubbed Explorer 1, the satellite's successful launch was the boost the American space program needed. Without Mary, the U.S. would have continued to trail behind the USSR in the space race. Mary's work was top secret, and she kept it that way. She was also fiercely private, and her accomplishments were lost among a litany of other amazing space achievements since. When she died, her son George sat down with some of her former North American aviation colleagues. One leaned over and said, "Your mom single-handedly saved the America space program, and nobody knows it but a handful of old men." Decades before Mary Sherman Morgan was working at the chemist's bench, Alice Ball was working on a better treatment for a very old disease, leprosy. In 1873, we learned, thanks to Dr. Gerard Hansen, that leprosy was caused by a bacteria. We knew the cause, and now we needed a better treatment. At the time, the best treatment for leprosy were injections of chowungra oil. But the results were spotty, the side effects were unpleasant, and the injections were painful. Despite all of this, scientists and physicians kept coming back to this nut oil. Something in it seemed to help patients. But what was it? That's where Alice comes in. Alice was a whiz at natural products chemistry, just the kind of work that was needed on chowungra nut oil. By early 1916, she'd cracked it. She developed a process to isolate active constituents in chowungra nut oil. These were fatty acids in the form of ethyl esters. Injection of these esters provided a more effective relief of leprosy symptoms with considerably less pain and discomfort than shots of the straight oil. The new treatment was used for decades afterwards. Sadly, 1916 would also see the end of Alice's all-too-brief career in chemistry. On New Year's Eve, at just 24 years old, Alice died. She never got to see the impact of her work on the treatment of leprosy. And for a long time, Alice never got credit. After her death, another chemist at the college continued her project, but published without any mention of Alice or her previous work. It was decades before the extent of Alice's contributions were recognized. Almost 90 years after her death, Alice Ball was awarded the University of Hawaii Regents Medal of Distinction. Finally, I want to recognize an exceptional woman from my alma mater, the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. Rachel Lloyd was a woman of firsts. In 1881, she was the first woman to publish research in a major American chemistry journal. In 1887, she was the first American and the second woman in the entire world to receive a Ph.D. in chemistry. That same year, Dr. Lloyd became the first female professor at a co-ed institution, UNL. Not everyone was thrilled to have her there. Just a year after her arrival, Dr. Lloyd survived an attempt by the chancellor to get rid of her, allegedly because of her Quaker religion. But UNL faculty supported Dr. Lloyd with a vote of confidence. Months later, the chancellor was gone and Dr. Lloyd was promoted to full professor. At UNL, Dr. Lloyd's research helped sugar beets become a major Nebraska crop and made sugar production a viable industry in the state. Today, Nebraska is sixth in the nation for sugar beet production, an industry that brings in millions to the state economy. You'd think Dr. Lloyd's life story and professional achievements would be better known, but details were nearly lost to history. Thankfully, due to a time capsule unearthed at UNL last year, we know more about Dr. Lloyd's pioneering work. We need pioneers like Mary Sherman Morgan, Alice Ball, and Dr. Rachel Lloyd. Explorers with grit and determination, though these three didn't always get the glory.
As well, like, subscribe, and share. Don't forget to check out our other Legends of Chemistry videos, accidental discoveries that changed the world, and tricking the Nazis and transforming medicine.